Hello, so this is finally the full release of the game. Now, as a fair warning, I have played Armor games for a lot of years and I would still play them if I, well, had the time. Armor games is a collection of free games that is actually very cool to waste your time, and sometimes you can even find hidden gems, like The Last Stand. They started off on Armor games, and Armor games is now a publisher. Con Artist Games, I think, is just the studio that makes The Last Stand games. I played all of their games, including the Facebook one, so I might be a little, you know, on their side. But to be honest, the game is not as good as I would have hoped for, or probably as good as the people who supported the game wished for. In my opinion, this still feels a little bit like early access from what I saw and from what I read on the page notes. So let's just play. They had a sudden change of heart and they didn't make it an open world game like they intended to. They made it kind of like a sort of roguelike. I don't know how to explain it. You'll just have to play and see it. I also fully intend to finish it because I finished Dismantle, and this is kind of similar to it, and that's why I like it. Hey, from one isometric zombie smasher to another, right? Because we love zombie games. Yeah, it's kind of a bad time to speak about the virus. They fell, oh man. Oh, if only they had known what would be in 2021. 5% are known as survivors. Yeah, so I think they should have made this kind of like an open world game where you had challenges, bosses, other stuff to do. Besides, you had the survival elements. They didn't need to kind of introduce this roguelike mechanic where you have to select a pathway and you have to bring back materials and, well, you'll just see. I'm pretty happy with what the game is right now and how it turned out, but again, it's not really... It didn't reach its full potential. I hope they continue to develop it. Besides, I didn't even get a key for this game. So, that means in a way I love it, in a way I hate it. So let's just see how the balance tips. Tank is empty. Herc is kind of like the government before. So you're supposed to play with random characters which are very ugly. And when you die, you get... Oh, I have the Taurus already. Yeah, the UI is a little worse than I would have expected. I mean, oh, I like rain. Let me enjoy the rain. So this is kind of like Hunt Showdown before. Okay, that's the fast reload. Like Hunt Showdown, you had to click. If you clicked left clicked, you attack with your melee weapon. If you clicked right, you would aim and then you would fire with your left. Pew! And a pew! And a pew! Oh, you can jump over the barricades, that's nice. Oh no, they kept that thing, so if you attack, you'll actually go forward like this. It's kind of like a stick-on system that I hate. It's probably made for consoles. Oh. Yeah, as I said, you can already see some things that should have been changed already. Why do you have a sticky attack like that? Reasons unknown. Herc. Yeah, the game is very sticky right now. Oh, my weapon broke. Yeah, I guess you're supposed to die over here. We gave it our best shot. I guess you could have won that if you played a little carefully and man, it doesn't really matter. We have a new survivor. Death is not the end. And the volunteers who are infected. So it doesn't really make sense. They are not. They're immune, but they are infected anyway. Doesn't matter. Tangier, based on their background, in the future will have more volunteers to choose from. Little pistol, some food, and we are off. Trinity and Stedman. Why? Oh. Cannot zoom on your character. The colony is starving. Okay, so the colony is actually with people that are immune, and the people that are not allowed inside are supposed to go on these suicide missions. Plus ammo, pick to dry, take this car. Car, Bessie. Some scientists, okay. Yeah, it's kind of generic, and they didn't even have voice dialogue for this. They could have had a little voice dialogue to introduce you to the story. Not to mention that the characters are a little boring, as you can see. This could have been vastly improved, Stedman. Are you Stedman? Yeah? You find catches, you fire up the beacons. Okay, so that's the basic gameplay. You find a lot of supply caches, and when we die, they get the... they get... what? They get the supplies. What's wrong with his arms? Does he have a baseball bat over there? A baseball? That looks so unnatural. Antiviral? Med base, okay. Herc. Homeland environmental control. They made this mess. They tried to bury it. The bombs, remember. Their gun? Long gone. Squirt away like that. Some safe houses out there, okay. How long do I have? 3 to 4 days typically. Mutation, okay. No, okay, let's go. So, the first 8 minutes of the game are basically stuff like this. The gameplay is good, don't get me wrong, the gameplay is good, but I think the stuff near the gameplay or after you do the gameplay is kind of annoying. Yeah, at least say goodbye to me, you jerks. Or wish me good luck, you jerks. So I guess I'll have 2 episodes ready, one after the other, because I really want to play more of this. It's such a pretty game, at least in my eyes. Yeah, find fuel stash. As you can see, we have a much smaller pistol. Well, let's just say that this pistol is a lot worse than the other one. Oh, we have a safe house. Yeah, look at how much you... No, I hate this sticky stuff. But I guess this is the way you should... be playing the game. It feels like I'm a superhero. Not even Batman could do some of the things we do right now. It feels like Batman Arkham Asylum. Oh, you use up your entire stamina. Okay, so you can light the barrel and nothing bad happens, right? So that's the fuel. It's pretty low quality. What do you mean? Does it have dust in it? Does it have sawmill in it? Bottom left, okay. Oh yeah, I forgot we have to carry the gas to the car actually. I think we'll get a flashlight later. I like this creepy atmosphere, to be honest. It says 1 out of 2, so there must be something else over here. I guess you just drop the gas can. Okay, hold. Man, so many... The controls are a bit backwards. Why do I have to press and hold? This is not a console game, or at least I'm not playing on console. Oh, okay, I forgot I can search the trunks of the cars, okay. Okay, it's coming back to me, and I think I like most of the game, yeah. But the bugs are still there. I mean, I don't know what they have been doing for the last 2 months, but the game is more or less the same as the demo and as... So it says 3 out of 1. I don't know why it says like that. It should just say... Oh, I have 3... Okay, I have 1 dose of 2. Oh, so... yeah, it's a little backwards. The design is a little backwards. I forgot about that Q thing. Okay, so we searched the 2 things that were inside the basement. We didn't find much, but the gas is nice. Yeah, I'm just getting used to the controls and some of the other stuff. 5. Okay, I guess we just need 1 unit of gas to get out of here. Oh no, it's coming back to me. There will be some weird things with the inventory system. I like that. I like that a lot. Okay, so we can search the trunk and the hood, under the hood. Yeah, but sadly, some of the cars you cannot search in the trunk like this. I don't know what triggers that or how do you tell. You just have to move next to all of them and kind of guess. Well, if it doesn't need repair, don't break it. Combat knife. So... Let me see, this is a blunt weapon, it has 9 DPS, damage is 27. Okay, I guess we are using the knife. So weight is 2, durability... I guess we'll save the knife for something better. Yeah, I think you can use the bottles mostly to distract enemies. Wait, let's not go the barrel on our back. So I'm taking it very, very slowly so people can see the mechanics and I can get used to them. Build up. I'm out of antiviral. Antiviral. Okay, first let's search the rest of the area. Oh, whatever that was, it was empty. Yes, that's kind of like the mini-map. I like the game a lot because it also reminds me of Atom RPG, if you can see some similarities in the design. Huh. I hope there's not an alarm or something like that. Infection from all sources. Good, good, good. One dose is enough, right? Turns out why? Doesn't make sense, but okay. You know, so what's in the boxes? I need to know what's in the boxes. I guess that's about it. The next area also have some tutorials because I remember it from the demo. I think you can still play the demo. Does it make sense that you drop the fuel can on the ground when you have a lot of room in your car? No, it doesn't. It will never make sense. Air blockade. So I guess you just travel to the next thing and then you reach the blockade. And this is more likely like FTL. I mean, you might run out of fuel, right? Or you just might run out of supplies, or you just might get wounded to finish the game. So at some point you'll just say, yeah, whatever, and restart the game. I'm curious about the roguelike mechanics. I don't want to die yet. Focus mode. Fly bag. There goes my stealthy approach. I guess at some point you just have to shoot them because, oh no. Not impressed by this. Press F like an idiot. Come on, game. Just give me a mini game. Press 5 keys in a row or whatever. Don't make me tap X like I'm tapping a button on the controller. Yeah. Green chance. Oh, wow. Stench. I like the. Reducing your maximum health. I guess that's also a nice thing because the more mutated you get, the more buffs you have. Yeah, forget about this melee business. It's so dangerous to do melee in the game. ...25 supplies. It looks like we have supplies on the back of the map as well. And do I look like I care about stealth? No, I'm joking and jumping. Later on we'll mostly do stealth. Okay, so that's inside. What about the... why would you need that? I guess if the zombies... okay. Not to stealth. Durability 10. Do we have a stealth kill? More or less. Also, as you can see, it will tell you how. Oh, she immediately came after me when I stopped using stealth. And there's a zombie over there. We didn't have a zombie before. So the zombie broke down the door. How do you throw things? Yeah, we have to check the options over here, the keyboard, because they don't tell us how to do that. Range weapon 1 and 2, focus mode, okay. T, consumable, quick craft, mutations, map. Yeah, it was something very silly that you had to do to throw the bricks. So yeah, can you get a new weapon? Can you repair the one that you have? Clean water, nice. Huh, that's very nice, I like it. So to get to the next zone, I will need 2 gasoline and we have 5, okay. Understand, what is this? What are, who? What? Wow, okay. I'm starting to like this game a lot more. So we have attachment slots over here. I guess we can attach stuff to it. They gave me an AK-47, they know how to please me. Equipped pocket items, so I have to press... Oh, okay, so... Okay, so I basically have to swap out my weapon. Oh, that's actually food. Oh, this is super annoying. Okay, unarmed. We have to switch to this one. But this doesn't have a lot of uses left. I guess you're supposed to fight very, very little. By the way, these are the slow walking zombies. Later you'll have fast walking zombies, which are more terrifying. And then you'll have running zombies and... a lot of other cool stuff. Okay, I guess that kind of tells us we can call the horde on us. Oh, that was 5.56, not exactly the caliber I need for the rifle. Okay, I don't know what's happening there, but let's pretend we don't care. Okay, so I'm taking it very, very slowly. Next time, the next video I'll play it a lot faster. I guess the goal is to find a lot of consumables that you can use on the zombies. Okay, so that was a power attack. You just have to click and hold the button, yeah. So in order to save durability on the melee weapons, you just have to use power attack. And then you can execute them. So that's 13. Okay, so if you execute them, you don't lose durability on the weapon. That's nice. That's an invisible wall. Oh, come on, game. It's 2021. Can we just simply lose the invisible walls? Can we just pretend they don't exist? That's a lot of zombies. So, I don't think we can gain experience in the game. So, if you decide to kill everything, that's kind of on you. You don't have to do it. I'm pretty sure the zombies have different stats. Okay, so if we don't eat, our maximum stamina is dropped. Yeah, that stupid lock on it, that stupid silly attack is annoying. As you can see, you can lose a lot of weapons that way. Okay, so the bigger guys are slower, but also take more damage and probably deal more damage. Knowledge, huh? Find an upgrade that ready to use this knowledge to prime. Oh, okay. So we have permanent upgrade points and also unlockable. Okay, don't that makes the game makes a lot more sense, yeah. It's full on roguelike, sadly. I would prefer the story mode or a sandbox. But I didn't do anything. Unarmed. I just wasted, again, the durability of the weapon. Does this mean that enemy is a lot more infectious? Yeah, it's super easy to get hit. Super easy to get hit because you're basically running into them when you're using the power melee attack or the melee attacks. Oh, okay, so the ones that are like that have glowing. Okay, if there are two of them, remember, if you hit them like this, you'll just stun them momentarily. Okay, I'm getting the hang of this. I guess we need a lot of construction materials to get through the game. Yeah, the AI is kind of bad. This is what some of the people who played the game and reviewed it said. The AI is bad. Oh, that's so cool when they make a lot of noise by breaking the glass doors. That's actually super cool. You can actually push them into the glass window by mistake and they'll actually make a lot of noise. The zombies will be attracted by the noise and forget about you. On the other hand, they'll... They're called the spare zombies because those are the spare zombies. They're not the original zombies on the map. Interesting design choices. I don't know what to say. Emergency guys, that's 4 points. It's also good that I show you how many nodes you have to search in the buildings. Okay, that was 40 minutes and we haven't done much. More melee damage and the zombies don't care so much about me. That's actually, those are actually pretty good upgrades. I think we can just... I'm pretty sure we can destroy stuff. Oh, those need a lot of points. Speed. Okay, so they are different, but you need an Anox, so... Constitution, poison resistance. Melee resistance. This one might be good. But probably the better ones are the aggressive ones. Feast or damage. Own distance, knockdown chance. Probably melee weapon will be one of the requirements to finish the game more or less. Survival upgrades. Oh yeah, action speed, chance to find more ammo. No. The first thing I'll upgrade is over here. This reminds me of what was that the game called with the brain stuff with the. The Evil Within, yeah, the Evil Within, where you put your points into whatever. Durability damage. Crafting chest also houses. Probably this one is the best one to find more stuff. And more XP on a volunteer dice. That's something else. Those are also very important. Okay, I guess in order to finish the game, you'll need more unlocks in order to build. An interesting concept. And like I said, I just wanted a proper RPG game, not a roguelike mechanic. Colonial Drive, I guess. You'll take damage if you go through there. Compound. Shipped mall or a gas station. I guess in the safe house we might find what we need. Oh no, we have a supply cache over there. I guess I wanted to go in the compound, but I guess we'll just go over here because we have the mall and the supply cache over there. And then the military outpost. And then the neighborhood and then okay. Let's just go to the next location, I'll end the video and we'll see each other in the next episode. Maybe I'll record 3 episodes because the game is starting to grow on me. And that was kind of like the introduction video where I learned the mechanics and play a little bit. I didn't play any minute before the game release, so the only things I knew were from the demo. But you can already see some of the problems with the design. Yeah, cannot hold extra gas in the car. I'll see you next time, bye.